Hey guys, welcome back. Time to keep exploring Kanto. We just got our ninth badge, the Thunder Badge, from Lieutenant Surge, and now I'm gonna head north, because this is the one way we can go, since there's a big, fat Snorlax blocking our way to the east. So, actually, I'm gonna talk to those guys. They seemed like they were just chilling. Let's see what's in these areas. So, that's a Snubbull. It's interesting. I assumed it would be Kanto Pokemon, but guess not. Okay, you have a cute Phanpy. Cool. Alright. Oh, they're having an argument about which Pokemon is the cutest, apparently. I personally vote Teddy Ursa. Teddy Ursas are pretty cute. They're like big teddy bears. And they evolve into awesome Ursa rings. Alright. Let's see what this guy has to say. He's blocking this door. Problem at the power plant. Well, that's something we're gonna have to check out eventually. But first, let's go to Saffron. Also, in case you've never noticed, all the cities in Kanto, they're all named different colors, and conveniently, the town you start in is called Palette Town, so it's like a painting palette, so that's kind of cool. Like, we just came from Vermilion City, I think that's like a shade of green, I'm not actually sure what color Vermilion is. Anyway, Saffron, which I think is like, you know, I don't really know, I think that's kind of embarrassing, I think it's like a shade of yellow? Maybe. Anyway, they're all colors, like Cerulean City is obviously blue, fuchsias, purple, Viridian, I think that one is green. Yeah, anyway, cool stuff. Let's see what this is. This used to be the... Oh, nope, that's the way out. Yeah, let's see if this is open. This used to be like the fighting practice gym or whatever. Karate King, Fighting Dojo, that's what it's called. The cave in Johto for training. Can we take this? Yes, we can. Focus Band. Cool. That's a held item. I'm pretty sure that makes it so you occasionally have a chance to not die and just go to 1 HP. Yeah. So if you get hit by an attack that would normally cause your Pokemon to faint, there's a chance, I don't know what percentage chance it is, to just live it with 1 HP, so that's pretty cool. Let me just check out this gym. Saffron City Pokemon Gym, Leader Sabrina, Master of Psychic Pokemon. So yeah, this is a Psychic Gym, and it's kind of annoying to navigate. Because in each of these rooms, there's usually a trainer, but there's also these four panels, and they each warp you to somewhere else. It's not random, they all go to the same place every time, but you kind of have to, well, either memorize the route, which I do not know anymore, or just kind of mess around until you find the way to Sabrina. That's probably what we're going to have to do here. And I think I mentioned this in a previous video, but these mediums look crazy. I mean, that's really freaky. Alright, so let's see, we're gonna go over here. There's 9 of these little rooms, it's in a square, three by three, so let's just kind of explore. Now let's go this way. Nope, that's where we came from. That was pretty stupid. Alright, so we may as well fight all these people while we're here. There's a Mr. Mime. Executes. And executes. Psychic Jared. Shit, back to the same room. Yeah, that happens a lot. Here's a room with nobody in it. I'm just gonna try all the tiles in this room, just so I know for sure that it's not helpful. Okay, so let's try all the tiles in this room. Alright, let's fight this person. Kind of just have to systematically go through all the tiles until you find the one that works. Or just get lucky early on. So, let's try this one. There's Sabrina below us. We already fought him. And try this one. Alright, now let's try all 4 tiles in this room. That's not it. That's not it, but we can fight this person. Nope. Fought her already. And this one is also not it. Okay, so we tried all the tiles in this room already, so we know it's not from here. This is the starting room, so that's not it. Let's try all the tiles in here. And... nope. It's gonna work eventually, I promise. We tried everything in this room already. And I think we tried everything in here, too. Yeah, see what I mean? This gym kind of just a pain in the ass. I don't think we've tried everything in here yet. So so it's not that one. There it is. Let me just remember. Okay, so it's in the top left room and the bottom left panel. Good to know if you're ever trying to play through this game. So here's the gym leader, Sabrina. I may as well heal. I think we just need a super potion. Yeah, we didn't get hurt much. And let's take on the next badge. That was fast. I knew you were coming. Well, that makes sense. She's a psychic. 3 years ago, I had a vision of your arrival. You're after my badge. How'd you guess? You're the fucking gym leader. Of course I'm here for your badge. I don't enjoy battling, but it's my duty as a leader. Ba-di-da. Since you wish, I'll show you my psychic powers. Alright, well, that's what I'm here to see, so let's see what you got. Sabrina, in her latex-looking suit, 10 out of 10, would bang. Anyway, she's gonna blend out with an Espeon, so that's pretty awesome. Espeons are one of my favorite Pokemon. And you will be seeing more of them in the Pokemon XD Let's Play that me and Bugburder are gonna do in a couple weeks. So that should be good. You'll get used to seeing Espeon. And you will like it. I promise. Alright, so there goes this one, though. And speaking of future Let's Plays, I'm going to continue this game and obviously finish it out, but I'm kind of starting to think about what I want to do next. And feel free to sound off in the comments if you have any suggestions. Until I get my new computer built in a week or so, I'm kind of limited to GBA or Game Boy Color games. And I was thinking of going with a randomized version of probably Pokemon Emerald. I found a program online that lets you randomize wild Pokemon encounters in the game. So I think that would be pretty fun to do a Nuzlocke in. If you don't know what a Nuzlocke is, I won't go into all the rules right now, but one of the important ones is that you can only catch the first Pokemon you find on each route. And so if all the Pokemon on the route are randomized, that could really make for an interesting playthrough, just to kind of see what you get. So that's my general plan forward plan, at least for the next thing I do a randomized Nuzlocke, probably in Emerald. I guess I could do it in like Fire Red or something else. Like I said, if you have any suggestions or comments, please let me know. Anyway, we just beat Sabrina, kind of just talked over that. She had an awesome Alakazam, but I guess we're just kind of overleveled for her, which is fine with me, because that was surprisingly easy. Yep, I'll become a celebrated beloved champion. Sounds good. So then we have to find our way back out of here. I'm just gonna keep randomly going. This looks promising. Yep, there it is. That was another fantastic battle. Hell yeah. Alright, so that was probably the easiest gym battle we've had so far. I wasn't even really paying attention, honestly. Well, this episode's only been going for like 8 minutes, so I think I'm gonna keep going for a bit. I normally cut it after whatever gym I'm at, but that was pretty fast. Let's go to the west and check out Celadon City, since we're here. See what's in this grass, I'm curious. Abra? And Snubbull. Alright, that was less interesting than I hoped. I think there's Houndours in that grass, which is really what I was trying to find, because those things are awesome. So go through the trees, and we get to Celadon City. The Poliwag's chilling there. Alright, heal up, and Team Rocket's hideout. Oh, that was 3 years ago. Yeah, so back in the first games, they had Team Rocket's hideout was in the game corner, and you had to clear them out of there. In this game, it was obviously in that kind of sketchy place in Mahogany Town, yeah. I think, yep, you can get into the back of this building. And from what I remember, you get something cool at the top, so let's see what there is. As we climb to the, I think, like, third or fourth floor, and go in this little house. What do you got? And recount a terrifying tale. Then again, it's not as scary. Well, it's still light outside. Come back after sunset, okay. Alright, that's not what I thought it was gonna be. I really don't know what that guy's gonna give you if you come back at night. I might try it later. But, in Red and Blue, that's where you get Eevee. And I was kind of looking forward to that, but apparently that's not the case in this game. So, my bad. Here's another big-ass department store over here, kind of like the one in Goldenrod. I don't really need to buy anything right now, though, so I'm gonna leave that alone. Let's see what this guy has to say with his own little pond in front of his house. Grimer have been appearing lately. See that pond out in front? Grimer live there now. Where did they come from? This is a serious problem. Yeah, that would be kind of gross to have Grimer all in your pond. Yeah, I remember this being kind of a special pond in the... because it's the easiest place to find Grimer. I'm sure you can find them other places in the game, but they're not super common from what I remember. Let's just see if we can find one. Yep, there it is. I definitely don't want it, but, well, if you're looking for Grimer, that's where you should look, in this guy's pond. Not weird at all. Here's the game corner. Let's see, I think I need a coin case first, which I get somewhere around here. If I can find it real fast, then I'll try and check out the game corner. We're holding an eat-a-thon contest. Okay. Crunch, crunch. Nobody here will give you a coin case. You should look in Johto. Well, that's weird that she knew exactly what I was looking for. I thought this was the place you got the coin case, but maybe I'm, again, remembering Red and Blue, and that's why they have that lady there to tell you that I'm wrong. In which case, I will have to get the coin case later. And I'm breaking his concentration. Sorry, dude. You should keep eating. Well, let's just go look in here. This is the exchange counter. Let's see what they have for sale. Oh, they won't even let me look without a coin case. Well, that's lame. Alright, well, we'll come back to that later, maybe. Let's go check out the gym in the meantime. And I know I said the gym we just did was probably the easiest gym we're going to do. I think this upcoming one is actually probably the easiest one we have left. And I need somebody that knows cut. I don't want to go get Totodile, so let's just teach it to Muscle. I'm fairly certain he can learn it. Yep, we're good. Alright, get rid of Vice Grip. And now he has 4 HMs, so he's really performing his duty admirably. Alright, this guy's a creeper. Let's see what he wants. This gym is great. Only the girls are allowed in there. Okay, so they changed his text. In the original game, he was standing right here by the window, just peering in and saying, and like said something like, haha, this gym is full of pretty women, or something like that. That was pretty great. It's an old guy creeping. Alright, so this is the grass gym, so Tiny Wings is gonna just destroy this place. I'm gonna kind of speed through here. I don't think there's gonna be a single Pokemon in this gym that's gonna take 2 hits to kill, so we should be set. Alright, yep, look at all my badges. Okay, Skip Bloom, and a Jumpluff, and a Hoppip. Cool team. Oh, bleh. Well, that was descriptive. Alright, that's one more guarding the gym leader. I was definitely not looking at the flowers. At you, don't worry. Just at you. Alright, there's a Paris. Parasect. Level 74, yeah. Alright, so here's the gym leader. This is Erica. Hello, lovely weather, isn't it? It's so pleasant. I'm afraid I may doze off. My name is Erica, I'm the leader of the Celadon Gym. Oh, all the way from Johto, you say? How nice. I'm sorry, I didn't realize that you wished to challenge me. Very well, but I shall not lose. Yeah, you will. You really got no hope. Alright, so she leads out with a Tangela. I believe all of her Pokemon are at least part grass. Tangela is just grass. And it really has no hope. Victory Bell? Nope. Jumpluff? Nope. Blossom? Nope. Alright, so yep, that's definitely our easiest gym. Yay. Tiny Wings deserves a break. And so this is the 2 badge episode, apparently. And it's still one of the shorter episodes I've made, so that's pretty funny. Giga Drain, that's actually a really good move. Tiny Wings can't learn it, but it's pretty strong, and half the damage you deal, you receive back is health, so that's pretty cool. Alright, so there's Erica and the Rainbow Badge. So we now already have 3 badges in Kanto. So that's this is going along pretty well. Next episode, I'm probably gonna head, let's see if there's a hidden item here. Yep, PP up, cool. Probably gonna head maybe west and head down Cycling Road, or check out what was up with the power plant that they're talking about earlier. So, thanks for watching, guys, and next episode we will continue to explore Kanto. See ya!